I am Rohit. Welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. In this particular video, I am going to show you one more technique for data exploration. In earlier video, we used df.info or df.describe method to get more insight of our dataset. But in this video, we are going to explore a new technique called pandas profiling. So let's jump into our Jupyter notebook and explore what is pandas profiling. So here I am in my Jupyter notebook. So basically, first of all, we look out what is pandas profiling. The pandas profiling is an open source Python module with which we can quickly do an exploratory data analysis with just a few lines of Python code. Besides, if this is not enough to convince to use this tool, it also generates an interactive report in web format such as in HTML format, and we can show this report to any person if they don't know any programming language. In short, what pandas profiling does is save us all the work of visualizing and understanding the distribution of each variable. It generates a report with all the information easily available. So working with pandas profile, the first requirement is to install pandas profiling module in our Jupyter notebook. So therefore I am writing this code that is pip install pandas profile, and for executing or run this cell I have to press a shift enter. When this asterisk is get converted into number, my cell is successfully get executed. So also I am created a playlist on pandas and a numpy. So those who are new to my channel or those who see this video first time, I am request you to subscribe my YouTube channel and also access my playlist on NumPy and pandas. So here you can see that the asterisk is converted into number and my cell is get successfully executed. And pandas profiling is get installed in my Jupyter notebook. So you can see already here requirement already satisfied because I can execute this command twice or thrice. But if you executed this command first time, it will show the another message. Afterwards, we working with data and we working with pandas profiling. So working with data and working with pandas profiling, we require some library called such as NumPy, library called such as pandas, and from pandas profiling we have to import a profile report because pandas profiling gives us a report in HTML format. Therefore we have to import some library such as NumPy, pandas, and from pandas profiling import a profile report. I have to press a shift enter to execute this cell. It will take a minute to execute this cell. So my cell is get executed and my required library such as pandas and NumPy, and I can import a profile report from pandas profiling. That library and this profile report it gets successfully executed. The next step in which I have to give or I have to set my working directory. So importing os library, and by typing os.change directory I can set my working directory, that is e drive in pandas folder. So whatever I am creating my HTML file, it will show, it will store in or save in that a particular folder, that is in pandas folder in e drive. Next step is to import my dataset. So working with pandas profiling, the main aim is to visualize or explore a dataset. So therefore we require a data. So here I am taking a housing dataset. So I am simply imported my dataset by saying pd.read_csv, and in close parenthesis I will mention my dataset with if extension, that is CSV. CSV is nothing but comma separated value. And for visualizing my data and for visualizing my first 5 rows of my dataset, I can simply write df.head. For executing this cell, I have to simply press a shift enter. So you can see over here, df.head will give me my first 5 rows. The next step is to create a report by using a pandas profile report. So I can write a command that is profile is equal to profile report, and I will have to give a hyperparameter such as my dataset. I have to mention my report title, and I have to mention explorative is equal to true, and I have to press a shift enter. Then I want to create a profile and a report. So first of all, it will create a profile how my report will look like. So therefore I have to write profile to widget and press a shift enter. So it will take a time, it will take a more than 1 minute, so we have to wait. So you can see over here, it will show me the report generated with pandas profile, but it does not show me the report. So I have to simply write a one command, and that command will generate my report in HTML format. That is this line. So I have to write a code such as profile.to_file, and I have to mention my output with extension of my HTML file. So I have to press a shift enter, and it will create my report in HTML format. It will take a more than minute according to your internet speed. And my report will get generated, and as I mentioned earlier, my report will store in this folder, that is in E drive and in pandas folder. So let's look how it's actually how it represents my dataset. So in pandas folder, and this is my file. So basically it shows you overview of your dataset, total number of variables, total number of observations, missing cells, duplicate rows, average record size in memory, means my two functions, that is dfinfo and dfdescribe, give me such kind of output, and and pandas profiling will combine that output in a very good manner, such as you can see over here the information of each and every variable can show over here. Later you can explore with various kind of dataset. You can see over here you can get a various kind of graph, such as correlation graph over here, and also in warning we can get the correlation without looking at the correlation matrix. So I think this method is very useful and powerful technique to get or explore a dataset. So if you like this video, please like it, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era, and press the bell icon and never miss an update. Thank you, one and all.